Pope Francis wrapped up a busy day in East Timor. After several meetings with church officials, the pontiff presided over Mass, and about half of the people who live in the mostly Catholic country turned out for the celebration.
Some 700,000 people gathered to celebrate Mass with Pope Francis on his last stop in East Timor. That's nearly half of the country's population. Hundreds of singers made up the choir. During his homily, the Holy Father applauded the culture of youth in East Timor. It's one of the youngest countries in the world, with a median age of just 20 years old.
Esta realidad se revela hermosa en Timor Leste porque hay muchos niños. Y ustedes son un país joven en el que en cada rincón la vida se siente palpitar y bullir. Y la presencia de cada juventud y de tantos niños es un regalo, es un don inmenso.
Earlier in the day, the Pope was welcomed by children with disabilities who were taken care of by the nuns of the Alma congregation. He thanked the sisters for what they do and also thanked the children.
Porque ellos nos enseñan a nosotros cómo debemos dejarnos cuidar por Dios.
After that meeting, the Pope went to the Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception in Dili, where he met with bishops, priests, religious, and lay people committed to the work of evangelization in the country. The Holy Father told them, "We need to be a missionary church, one that goes out of its comfort zone to evangelize."
En el Evangelio, los confines son el centro. Y una iglesia que no tiene capacidad de confines y que se esconde en el centro es una iglesia muy enferma.
Pope Francis heads to Singapore on Wednesday, where he's set to meet with members of the Society of Jesus, the president and prime minister, and host an interreligious meeting with young people. Hi, I'm Christine Persichetti, anchor of Currents News. If you like what you saw, please hit the like button on this video. And if you want to see more content just like it, subscribe and click on the bell for notifications. Thanks for watching, because we are putting your faith in the news.